Okay. Let's see if sound is still synchronized. I'm going to talk loudly. Sound is still synchronized. Okay, that's okay. Nice. Okay. Welcome back to Read Only Memories. No, they did not. I had to check some things. The audio receptors are one of its more visibly damaged parts. Aw, dang it. Don't touch it. It's still evidence and there's no putting it back together. Hey, I have headphones. There's no Polizei at my door, and it's called Polizei. I'm not in Germany, so... Ah, our personal computer is not password protected at the moment. Give me a moment to look through her files. Best to keep your fingerprints off of the keyboard. Most of this isn't very interesting. Committee reports, financials, article submissions. Oh, here we go. According to this email between Zinn and her network admin, her lead on TMI Entertainment is a little more solid than she led us to believe. Yemen ran a web crawler looking for changes in writing styles. Some blog posts by their head anchor Charlie Nova stood out like a sore thumb. Apparently he's a bit pompous, if in an affable way. And his blog, shit, I accidentally clicked. But ever since the human revolution has been in town, he's been smearing them with more venom than you'd expect considering how neutral his on-air reporting has been. Zinn seems to think he was just complaining about the protesters fouling up traffic, and whoever is manipulating these posts spun it to make him look critical of the movement as a whole. Just like the Augmented Eye journalist. This Charlie fellow is the one we need to talk to. Okay. Picture of a 2P is an odd thing to a frame. Oh wait, that's an animal of some kind. What is it? At least you think it is? God damn it. My thermal sensors only detect a single set of lingering footprints, and they end almost 3 feet away from the window. Considering the density of this glass, I can't imagine Zinn jumped from that far and managed to throw herself through the pane without help. But who could have done it? I don't see any obvious marks on the floor or any other thermal hotspots. You're saying no one else was in here? It doesn't look like it. We should go, Flint. Is there anything else in here? The police are almost on the scene. We can't afford to be slowed by undue suspicion. Son of a! I should have figured the two of you would be here. You just won't stay out of trouble no matter what I say, will you, Flint? Lay off, will you? You don't know what you're talking about. Oh yeah? Give me one good reason why I shouldn't drag your ass in for questioning right now. I assure you, Detective Rivers, we are merely in the wrong place at the wrong time. We had an appointment with Zinn to discuss a possible lead and found her office in this state of disrepair. Of course you did. Damn it. Fine, fine. Get the hell out of here before anyone else shows up. But mark my words, the two of you will be answering my questions when I'm not scraping people off the pavement, you hear me? Certainly, Detective Rivers. I'll forward you a report of what we know immediately, and we can speak further at a later time. Yeah. Yeah, whatever. Get moving. Why did you lie to Lexi? We could have told her about the articles. I do not need you to infer upon my motivations or highlight my duplicity. Detective Rivers has every bit of information that Zinn gave us on that computer. Their investigation will not be hampered by our absence, whereas ours is halted if we start giving answers she can just as well get from her hard drive. Literally. Has it occurred to you that whoever threw Zinn out of the window could be after the same thing we are, except to silence the story rather than to get it out? We have little time for fooling about, and we must get to Charlie Nova before something happens to him too. Now, unless you have further recriminations to level at me, we must not squander the time my dishonesty brought us. I have highlighted the main Neo San Francisco offices for the TMI Entertainment on your map. Let's go. I hope some pity for me still remains considering my recent tone, because I'm honestly not sure where we should start, Flint. I suppose we should just ask the receptionist to point us to somebody who can answer our questions. Sounds like a plan. Hello?
Welcome to TMI Entertainment Incorporated. Do you have an appointment?
No. We need to talk to whomever is in charge.
I really can't let you in without an appointment. I can maybe pencil you in for the next Wednesday? We don't have time for this! People's lives are on the line here, and all you care about is appointments?
I'm downturning.
Oh, look, if it's that important, I can buzz you through the sympathy. But she isn't going to be very happy about being bothered off the schedule, so don't get your hopes up. And, try not to make her too mad. I'll be the one dealing with the fallout. Right, of course. I apologize. We will be as tactful as possible, I assure you. Okay. She's over on the other side of the room. Head straight there. She doesn't like it when people bother the talent.
Is it this guy? Or is it this guy? This is assistant newsroom employee. Producer.
I told Nina to cancel all my appointments for the day. I swear that girl can't find her ears with both hands, even if she does make a damn good cup of coffee. You would think with ears like hers, she wouldn't have such selective hearing.
Are you sympathy? Nina said we should speak to you.
Yes, of course I'm sympathy. What do you think keeps the clocks running around here? So, what the hell are you doing in my building?
We've been given a lead on the story that involves one of your employees, Charlie Nova. You might not have noticed, but someone has been manipulating posts going out on the net to make them more extreme against the human revolution, including articles posted by Mr. Nova. We're trying to track down the culprit, and we need to talk to Mr. Nova to hunt down further leads.
You let your ROM do all the talking for you? Must be one of those new interrogation modules all the fresh meat are raving about.
Huh.
Look, of course I know someone's been modifying Charlie's articles. I'm in the midst of tracking them down myself. What I want to know is why should I help you snatch the scoop out from underneath me? Super hacker twists Meshnet news for personal political vendetta? The clicks basically farm themselves.
We are willing to trade info with you.
Not interested. I already have a pretty decent idea of where to look next. And if that doesn't plan out, I have our primary server cluster chewing through the mesh posts, looking for inconsistencies. I figure this one out on my own, without some newbie mucking things up.
I'm willing to break the story under TMI's banner. Say that to Zinn.
Zinn? When did I Zinn? What does Zin have to do with this?
She's the one who gave us the lead to begin with. Then... someone threw her out of her office window! Office window! We figured Mr. Nova might be next, and we wanted to get to him before they did.
Holy shit. Fine, I'll let you two talk to Charlie. If someone is trying to kill people over this, I'd rather be out and done with it as fast as possible. Even if I lose the scoop. We're an entertainment zine, and I'm not willing to have any of my people die for this story. But that doesn't mean you get to stomp all over Charlie to get what you want. He's a pompous clown, but he's my pompous clown. Keep it civil, or I'll throw your ass out of here and figure this out on my own. Now get on it. I need to make some calls. Is him? I think that's him.
Hey there, I'm Sky. Nice to meet you. This is just my side job for me. For my main gig, I run a gym. Sky High Gym, right by the campus of the M.
Okay, cool. Is it you? Fantastic! How fantastic! I just love your ROM. Not quite as stunning as mine, but still pretty grand. Very sleek. Very clean. Bravo. Oh, Sympathy is doing that thing where she waves at me to hurry things up. Right, down to the brass tacks then, I suppose. Wait, how about I introduce myself? I'm Charlie Nova, host of Tonight in the Stars and Star in the Stratosphere. But you already knew that, I'm sure. What can I do for you?
Why don't you tell me a little bit about yourself?
Oh, you flatter me. Yes, you do. I can't imagine you've come all this way just to get my story, have you? After all, I've already published my very own splendid autobiography, Like a Nova. But I suppose I can give you a quick rundown, even if Sympathy is giving me the stink eye. I grew up here, on the mean streets of near San Francisco, but my joke. Jocular nature and striking countenance got me scouted for a few small product advertisements. And the rest is history. Now I'm the host of the largest celebrity news show on the mesh, and I couldn't be happier. It is all thanks to my fans, though. They're the ones who count.
Yes, any additional information on your situation would be greatly appreciated.
Well, I can tell you that it's the best damn network on the planet. I can confirm that it's 100%. That 100%, absolutely. We're top-notch in news and entertainment, but with real heart that our competitors just can't match. If you really want to know about TMI, you need to know about Sympathy. It's her pride and joy, after all. Sure, she can be a little... Oh, okay. And sure, she calls me a poofy head oaf all the time, but you can really tell she cares, you know, deep down. I'm not sure if that throat-cutting gesture she is making is a signal to move to another topic or a threat against my physical well-being. So, let's move on. What next?
Have you heard that your stories are getting altered once they get posted to the mesh?
It may have come up in the last lunch meeting we had, but Sympathy assured me that it was some kind of technical glitch, and our support people were on top of it. They're top-notch. The absolute best money can buy. The absolute best money can buy. But I don't think there's any more to say on the subject.
You're telling me you don't own anything at all? Look, Charles, we're just trying to get to the bottom of this.
Let's do this. It's very upsetting. I hope that you've passed along that information to Sympathy. I'm certain our tech people will be able to find the culprit in short order once they have enough information. I don't really know what I have to do with it, though.
Chuck, I'm sure you're better informed than that, right? It was your post that they were manipulating.
That is supposed to mean what? It's not clear to me if you're trying to imply that I had something to do with this or that I'm being targeted for some specific reason. But if you have an accusation to level, then make it known. My time is far too important to be wasted on beating around the bush. Alright, that's enough. Charlie has a show to get ready for, and I can't have you wasting any more of his time. He's told you everything he's going to.
Apparently that's a woman. So should I do a higher pitched voice?
He's told us everything he's going to.
To get the hell out of here.
If you find anything more interesting than what you've got, come back and see me again. Directly.
Okay, bye.
Oh man, she looks really cheesed off now. Do you know how snippy she can get? I better get her coffee ready, maybe that'll calm her down. I'm very sorry if you made your day more difficult. Perhaps I could take the coffee over to Sympathy and we could try to smooth her rumpled feathers? Yeah, okay, sure. I mean, what's the worst that could happen? You make her even madder? On second thought... It'll only take a minute! Alright, but it takes... But she takes it with plenty of milk.
I thought I told you to beat it. What do your ears not just not work?
I want to bring you coffee and make sure there were no hard feelings.
Ha! I'm not petty enough to hold a grudge just because you're leaning on Charlie a little harder than I'd like. Sometimes I think the product he uses on his hair seeps into his brain. But I've got a business to run, and you're mucking it up. Now scram, you know how to get in touch with me if you need me.
That did not go well at all. We need some kind of leverage to get Mr. Nova to give us the information we want. I'm certain he knows something. Don't you agree?
He was being pretty evasive.
Indeed. While you were talking to him, I took the opportunity to look into his history more thoroughly. It turns out he did a series of promos for the local Hassy Bar earlier in his career, and some fans still spot him there from time to time. It's a long shot, but frankly, everything about his case has been one long shot after another. Maybe we should question the people at this Hassy establishment and look for any dirt we can use to put some pressure on Mr. Nova. There must be something. That's the only path I see.
Sure.
Hassy Bar is located on Market Street, near the Genus Clinic. You can head there whenever you're ready.
Uh-oh. That girl is going to be angry because of her rom.
Well, if it isn't the luckiest jerk I've ever seen in my life. I had to schedule a specialist to come fix my ROM, and you better hope they can. Oh well, all's well that ends well. I underestimated how much people would appreciate an early Christmas. Anyway, what can I do for you?
Oh, okay, that was good. I was hoping you had some time to talk.
Sure. I still have a little bit before closing. I could use some conversation to distract me from the anticipation of the VR drama I have waiting for me when I get off. What do you want to know?
I heard Charlie Nova did some promos for this place. What's he like?
Charlie's a complete trip. We met when he was just starting out doing adverts, and he still drops in every once in a while to hang out. I love the guy. He's super funny and always has the best stories, and his hair is perfect. And he parties harder than anyone I know. A couple weeks ago, he invited me to his rave, to this rave at some hole.
Wow, that's a lot of. Lot of text.
That's some hole that's probably already shut down. And he got so amped up on Crash that he jumped up on a table and hosted an impromptu dirty dancing contest. I swear, if it wasn't Charlie Nova, we would have gotten chucked out of our asses. Out on our asses. But it was a lot of fun. You want to meet him?
just hanging around here long enough. He loves mingling with his fans. Not that it helps his ego any. This is pretty innocuous. We're going to need more evidence if we're going to fabricate a believable story that will convince Mr. Nova it's in his best interest to help us. Can you tell me about the VR technology? You don't have any internal hookups, do you? The older sets are all helmets that use electromagnetic waves to stimulate the neural pathways in your brain to induce the desired sensory input. It's pretty crude, though, which is why EM hats give you that dreamlike experience. It doesn't quite feel real. The direct link network has way higher fidelity. It's like actually being there. And since the direct link can interrupt your primary motor cortex, you don't have to take muscle relaxers to keep from flailing around. But some people are still scared of by it. Why is that? Well, it's pretty invasive. They inject this smart polymer into the base of your skull, right at the brainstem, and it crawls along your primary neural pathways and bonds to your major sensory centers. Sensory centers. It's been safe for almost a decade, but a lot of folks are still pretty skeeved out by the idea of having a bunch of conductive plastic coating in the inside of their brains. I can understand that. Plus, for the 24 hours or so that it's hooked everything up and self-calibrating, you start to have intense hallucination because of all the electrical crossfiring. It's a trip, I'll tell you that, but no worse than the stuff people have been taking for millennia, watching the world melt. Anyway, if you're looking to get installed, I have a guy who does great work. Just let me know. What's the VR drama about? Oh, it's an ongoing drama called Magical Commander Yukino. Yukino at the gates to the deep. In it, you play the magical girl Yukino as she fights off elder gods as they arise from the ocean. It's a bit cliched and just about as silly as you would expect, but it includes some... Hello, Killer Roosabot. Sure. Some really interesting intersection between the Japanese magical girl trope and the American Cthulhu mythos. All with a pseudo-military theme. In the newest episode, Yukino has to face off against the Yith as they try to inhabit the bodies of people in the present to escape their destruction in the past. Is it like a video game?
Not really.
Video games are about winning and manipulating the mechanics of the system to get ahead, right? Let's not do that. You can just tell me what the game is. Dramas are more about inhabiting the role of the character. There are rules, but they're mostly about behaving consistently in the fictional world. It's a bit like being in an improv theater, except if you get too far out of your character, the system boots you out. And you have to start the episode over. Everyone experiences the drama a little differently, but it stays broadly consistent because you have to maintain the behavior of the character you're inhabiting. It requires you to really get inside the head of another person. I like it better than VR games, but that's just me. Sounds exciting. Maybe I'll look it up.
It's the best. Super awesome. If you need any other suggestions, just let me know.
Shadowrun Returns. Shadowrun Returns. I have heard of that. It seems pretty cool. Like, I have not played any of the Shadowrun games, but I heard it was a pretty cool cyberpunk RPG on the SNES originally. And of course, Shadowrun Returns. And I think there was a Hong Kong one. A Hong Kong one. Or something. I don't remember what it was. But those are for PC, of course. It seems cool. Maybe I'll take a look at it.
I played through a little bit of everything. I'm sure I could find something you'll like.
Maybe a detective drama?
Anyway,
I think I'll make some small talk with the other customers.
Sure, just let me know if you need anything. I'm always happy to help.
I haven't seen you around here before. Is there something I can help you with? Another one of his fans, huh? Yeah, he comes here sometimes. I don't really get why everyone likes him so much. What's your issue with him? Well, I have a picture from his time, from this time he flipped off a box of kittens. Somebody brought them to try to give away, and one of them scratched him up. He ended up taking it home, but he really hammed it up about getting scratched. I think he ended up calling him, I think it was Captain Snuggles. It was pretty funny, actually. I'll send your ROM a picture. Hey, dude. Keith.
Oh, hey, it's Flint. Wow.
Who's this?
This is Keith, an old buddy of mine. Oh, good to know.
Hey, not too old now. It's great to see you, though. Sort of surreal, though, too. You're never around on social sites or anything, you know? I bet you didn't see any of the pictures I put up from my last climbing trip in Colorado. Did you manage to keep that plant I got you alive?
Yeah, totally.
Really? I haven't seen it in forever. For a tech journalist, you do have a pretty poor net presence.
That's what I told them.
That's just like them. So what's with the bot?
That's Turing, my ROM.
Yours, really?
Huh, I didn't think you'd like to bring Burke home, as it were.
Anyway, it's great to see you. What brings you to the Hassy Bar? Doing a review of that sweet weather ROM outside or something?
Actually here on an investigation.
Alright! Now that's the kind of journalism I'm talking about. Indeed, we're looking into some accusations made against Charlie Nova. And we're actually trying to build up a solid case against him. No shit. I actually may have exactly what you need. Charlie comes here all the time. You know that show he's the host of, Star in the Stratosphere? That show where they let normal people try it for real acting and singing contracts and stuff?
Okay.
Listen to this recording I made when he was here last month on his book tour.
So many people come up to me thinking that if they can sing or act, I'll just make them a superstar. That isn't how it works. Raw talent is enough to get you by in this industry, and anyone who thinks so is lying to themselves. It takes hard work and persistence. You've got to want it, and want it bad.
Spits hot fire.
Okay. Spicy Cheetos. But the kits I get on Star in the Stratosphere, which I host each and every week, as all you know, they are so young and hungry. I love them. I do my damnedest to make sure they get what they want. They give me their best, so I'm gonna give them mine.
Okay.
It's not much, but it might help you build a case if you spin it right. Maybe edit clips together and mash it into something sinister if you're desperate. Here, I just made a copy for you. Anyway, I'd love to catch up soon. For now, I'll let you keep at it. You can usually find me here if you want to chat again.
Thanks, Keith. Later.
Flint?
Why did you tell Keith that I belong to you?
More convenient that way. Very fair, you may continue to run with that as your story with those who don't or shouldn't know the truth about me. Anyway.
We call pepper spicy. There's only one type of pepper out there that's spicy. They are bell peppers. Okay. And the rest. Everything else is hot.
Frankly, I'm starting to feel a bit uneasy about this, Flint. Mr. Nova is clearly an upsetting individual, if just a bit boisterous. But I suppose if we're in for a penny, we're in for a pound. There should be more than enough anecdotal evidence to fabricate a less than flattering image of Mr. Nova, the public will eat right up. But let us present our story to him immediately. Hopefully our delay has not put him in physical danger.
Oh, whoops. Not menu. No. Leave.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, you two! I think I'm gonna have to let security know it, that you're not allowed back at the building.
I've got some stuff that might change your mind about teaming up.
Doubtful, but let's hear it. Never let it be said that I didn't give someone a chance to dig their own grave.
Not much of an animal lover, are you, Charlie?
Hey! That's completely out of context! And I love Captain Snuggles. Sure, we didn't get off to a good start, but he's a great cat, the best.
Charlie, flipping off a kitten? Why?
Anyway, this is just pathetic. This is really your best attempt at blackmailing us?
So what? I like to show people a good time.
There's nothing wrong with that. Damn it, I told you to get off the crash, Charlie. Shit like this keeps coming up.
I did! And besides, I wasn't doing anything illegal.
Whatever, this is still nothing but hot air. You need to step up your game, kid.
Ha! You're just grasping at straws. This speech was truly a beacon of light to the entire entertainment community. There's no way an original sermon like that is going to convince anyone that I'm a bad guy.
Well, with some creative editing... Alright, so maybe you've got enough to make a bullshit sandwich some old rube might eat. But if you go public with this flimsy smear piece, I'm gonna tear you apart.
Oh, enough! Enough! I'm not cut out for this cloak and dagger game sympathy. What's the big deal anyway? It's not like they've got anything solid to use. Might as well give them what they want so they'll go away.
Fine, whatever. It's on your head, Nova. I'd rather lose out on a scoop than spend my days cleaning up this mess anyway. Tell them whatever you want. And I'll be taking that evidence.
You didn't have to do all of this. I would have helped if you had just asked. But it's always push and dig and needle, isn't it? I'm not a journalist. I'm just an anchor. I read off of a teleprompter and look good doing it. I don't have much to offer you, but here's what I know. Trust me, I'd love to lay down some earth-shattering pronouncement and dazzle you with my investigative skills, but all I've got is flimsy threads at best. The thing is, all this stuff with my stories, stuff getting changed, making me look like I don't like the human revolution or whatever, it started after I had an upgrade made to my VR uplink hardware. A technically legal kind. Look, I like to have a good time at a party, right? But sympathy keeps hammering on me for pounding back too much crash and whatnot. Nothing illegal, but she says it makes me look like shit on camera the next day. So I went to this guy I know. Good guy. Everyone uses him. He's called Nonia. He does great work. After just one simple back alley brain surgery, bing bang boom. I can use an app to make my VR uplink have the same effect on my brain that the Sims do, without all the nasty physical side effects. It could be a coincidence though. The tech guys can't find anything wrong with my uplink, and they say the modifications check out. But that guy does a lot of work for the media people around here, so if a bunch of posts are getting changed, maybe Nonia is the weak link.
I think it's some kind of drug. It would make sense. Like,
they made up a new drug. Because they probably couldn't use crack or something. Anyway, that's it. Pretty flimsy, but I have my ROM pass this address to your ROM, and you can go talk to him. If he'll even see you, that is. Thanks for the help. We took far too long to get to it, but I'm quite happy to assist in any way that I can. Just make sure you source me in your article, yeah? Maybe run a rough draft past me, and I'll give you some quotes. I'm certain that'll help signal boost the story all the way to the stratosphere. Give it to the old Charlie Nova bump. Maybe we can smooth out all this silliness between us. Anyhow, I really have to get back to work. Let me know how things go with the hacker thing. Okay. I guess we go here. Trash.
This looks like the spot. I'm awfully nervous and still a bit shaken up. Let's hurry and get out of here. Hold up there, Speedy!
I've never seen the two of you around here before, and I know everybody. Why don't you let me know what's going on here first before you start barging through people's doors? Feel me?
Hello, we're just here to speak to Nonia about something.
You just got into town and you're already asking favors from folks, huh? Tsk. My little blue friend.
What? No, it's not like that. Listen, we don't want any trouble, but we're kind of in a hurry.
BTL, okay.
Trouble? There's no trouble here. We can be friends.
For what price?
Hehe.
I like this one. You're a little more street smart than your blue bot buddy here, I see.
Nah, I like you too. You're cool in my book.
And since we're all such good friends now, maybe you'll be willing to give back to the community and do a favor for your new pal Formula first.
What kind of favor?
Better than life. Ah, cool.
You see, I'm a budding street musician, working on my next big hit, feel me? But I'm sort of stuck on a few lines. I just gotta get these last few rhymes right. Maybe you could share a little of your creativity with me and see what we come up with. Come on, it'll be fun!
Okay, sure.
Are you sure about this, Flint? You know how important this has become. Time is of the essence.
You don't have time to not help me.
Huh?
What do you think would take longer? Helping an up-and-coming singer-songwriter finish a guaranteed worldwide hit? Or you could ignore me and maybe I'll send over an anonymous tip to the Neo SFBD. You see, I know for a fact that everything inside the shop here is 100% legal, but I bet whatever you've got on your mind sure ain't. Even if they didn't find anything, I'd take the rest of the day to iron out. People like you don't come here down here for anything boring. We clean up good. Oh, how well do you think you cover your tracks when you're in such a hurry, I wonder?
This isn't good, Flint. If Lexi in particular gets suspicious and starts tracking us down, things will become rougher for us. Not to mention all of the other people it could indirectly affect. This whole case is life or death.
Huh, kind of a dramatic rum, ain't it? But I made my point clear. If you don't help me out, I'll make sure you never get in to see Nonia at all. He's my buddy. Done me a favor too, so I'll return him what I'm asked. So I return him what I'm asked. That's how we do things around here.
Fine, we'll help you finish your damn song.
I knew you'd see it my way. All you gotta do is help me complete my rhymes, you dig? A couple of them are just missing a word or two, but if I really want to make this song fantastic, I'm gonna need some killer inspiration. It's gonna be super cred. Anyway, you ready for this? Let's do it.
Gonna give it a shot, that's what I like to hear.
Here's the first line I'm having trouble with. You ready? It's my favorite season, only comes once a year. I'll show you the true meaning of my holiday cheer. Hey, yeah, that totally works.
I love your inspiration.
Eddie, thanks a ton. Here's the next line. Ready? Pay attention now. If you bring mistletoe, you'll knock me off my guard. And if you want my number,
You know, for this one, I don't think words are gonna be enough. I'm gonna need some inspiration to make it come together. If you've got anything to show me that you think will help me out, let me know. Business card.
If you bring the mistletoe, you'll knock me off my guard. But if you want my number, I'll give you my business card. Hey, that totally works. Really, thanks so much. I'd never be able to write a song like this without you.
The Christmas-themed love song? Aren't those supposed to be pretty tacky?
Alright, now I need to help you with just one more line. I promise it's the last one. This one's been driving me up a wall. I hope you can tackle it as well as the others. Ready? Here you go. This is harmony. I think we're vibing the same tones. We can write this beat with a nice pair of damn it. This is getting embarrassing.
Headphones.
This is harmony. I think we're vibing the same tones. We can write this beat with a pair of GX Ultra Beats? This rhymes. GX Ultra Beats? Come on.
Card. Brochure. Medium range pistol. ID card.
Come on. You could have said pair of headphones. You could have said, God damn it. That's stupid.
Do I need to look around for items? Rubbish.
A nice pair of an electromagnetic pistol mixer.
Cat.
Kitty starts to sway its tail as you stroke it.
Does that mean it's happy?
Little kitty squints his eyes and says, "Weh." No idea what it means at all.
Toy boy.
A pair of headphones would have been...
God damn it.
GX Ultra Beats, come on.
Oh, cool. Can play music.
Box of donuts. Take old donuts.
Just gonna give him donuts.
Where?
There you go. A pair of box of donuts.
Air conditioner, garage door. Okay, it has to be an item. I can't use the headphones.
This is harmony. I think we're vibing the same tones. We can ride this beat with a pair of yummy Christmas cones.
What the fuck? He doesn't know that those are donuts, right? That was stupid. Now that's what I call a tasty beat. That was amazing! I can't believe you pulled it off! Whatever you do for work now, it doesn't matter. You should become a musician. We totally become rivals, and I bet you that. On second thought, keep your day job. This is my territory, you feel me? But you did help out in a huge way, so I guess you're cool. Go on in and see Nonya whenever you want. I'll just be chilling around here, soaking up the inspiration of my surroundings.
You can keep the scones. It's nice meeting you, Formula. Hey, you too, little bot blue.
Hey, that kind of rhymed. Let's go. Hi. Nope. Yup. Nope. I don't know you. You got something? Someone willing to vouch for you? If not, get out of my shop!
We just met Formula. He said we were cool.
Mula, that guy's a hoot. Keeps out of the riffraff and fakers too. Seriously, where did you hear about me?
Charlie Nova said I should come talk to you.
Charlie? Yeah, I remember him. A TV guy. Runs his mouth a lot, yeah. Be good enough. Alright, then. What can I do for you?
Charlie said your name is Nonya?
Sure. If that's what you want to call me.
Nikolai cannot die.
If your credit's clear, you can call me whatever you want. Enough foreplay. What can I do for you? A fresh install, custom firmware, maybe an upgrade. I can pretty much do it all, but most people come in here for VR implants. Turns out brain surgery is expensive, yeah.
We're here on a different kind of business. We're in a bad situation. Local news articles are being mysteriously altered after they've been posted on the mesh, even while the originals are still online. Charlie Novas are being manipulated as well, and he pointed us in your direction. It didn't start happening until after you had this implant upgraded. Do you know anything about that?
What are you, cops? No, worse. You're journalists. Get the hell out of my shop! I have a business to run. I don't have time to answer shit about shit that don't got shit to do with me. You found the door before, find it again. And tell Charlie he can get someone else to do him a rush job when he's back on the stims and needs to work around. He ain't welcome around here anymore.
Give us a moment, please. I don't know about you, but I'm getting tired of being given the runaround by these meat bags. We could just find some bribe or blackmail to get what we want from this Nonya, but I think it's time to take matters into our own hands. I have an idea. Keep him occupied for a few minutes.
Or should I do that?
Just do what you normally do and ask questions. Nothing about the blog posts, though. We don't want to set him off. Just keep him talking. It'll only take a minute.
Are you gonna get going, or am I gonna have to call someone to make you get going?
I think we got off on the wrong foot.
Damn straight! Now get out of here!
Listen, we don't think you had anything to do.
I didn't.
We were just hoping to get some more background information on the kind of implant he has so we can follow other leads.
Shit. Fine, whatever. I'll tell you what you want, within reason. Doctor-patient confidentiality and that. Just promise me it'll get you the hell out of my shop a little sooner.
Deal. Sorry for this. Our circumstances have gotten serious, and we're following anything we can all the way to the end.
There's no way to hack a VR implant like Charlie's. I mean, you can definitely install hostile firmware on one. You can't just load whatever program you want without the user's knowledge. Any changes to the loaded firmware will trigger really obvious visual indicators to let you know something is being changed. And those are put in on the hardware level.
I've never heard of anyone being able to circumvent them. The only person who could have loaded hostile firmware on there is me. And I get paid to do my... I get paid too much to risk my reputation over changing a few blog posts.
What about using the mesh to mess with the implant? Is there some way to change the input remotely?
No, the implant itself doesn't have any kind of wireless connection. You have to use a headset with an induction coil for I.O. Wireless just doesn't have the bandwidth for it. You might be able to try infecting a ROM with some virus that screws with the I.O., but you can only use a connection to a ROM for AR HUDs. They can't handle full simulation. You need a full rig and a hardline connection to the net to do that. So, I give a big maybe. If that's actually how it all happened, they probably would have found whatever infected this ROM way before you showed up here to bother me.
Could it have just been faulty parts? Not to be too blunt about it, but this area is a little disreputable. Maybe your supplier sent you an implant with something fishy preloaded?
Damn it! Look, I get it. I'm working out on an old auto garage on the bad side of town. But I'm a fully licensed cyber surgery tech. This entire business is legitimate. It isn't illegal to install custom parts or firmware in any current generation implants. It just breaks the warranty. My business keeps a low profile so we don't run into bogus patent infringement lawsuits from Flower Cybernetics or whatever shell company they decide to come after you with. All of my parts are sourced direct from the original manufacturer, completely above board. So if they're bad, they were built bad by the factory. Now is that all? I have appointments to keep. Thanks
for your time.
Yeah, whatever.
You may not know this, but I have a finely tuned sense of electromagnetic fields. All ROMs do. We need to be able to maintain optimal contact with the mesh, catalog and use various wireless transmissions, and avoid areas with dangerously high interference. Your stock off-the-shelf ROM has very little command over the frequencies available to be scanned. But I'm starting to realize how very little of me is stock or off-the-shelf. After the changes Hayden made, and that means when the humidity is low, the air fairly sings for me, amongst other things. But I digress. Von Eck freaking is a methodology by which you can scan the electromagnetic radiation emitted by the cathode ray tube inside a monitor. Von Eck freaking is a methodology by which you can scan the electromagnetic radiation emitted by the cathode ray tube inside a monitor and recreate the original signal remotely. Meaning, in layman's terms, I can read his monitor over his shoulder while being across the room. CRT. Okay. Well, some. I doubt I could have handled an LCD monitor. They require extra parts I just don't have. Yeah, the big one. And the fidelity is a bit low. But we're in luck. It wasn't. Anyways, Donia looked up his client records on Charlie, and I got some of the names of his other customers off of the spreadsheet. One in particular stands out. Shotaro Otsuka. Sounds flimsy. As if everything else on this wild goose chase hasn't been. Mr. Otsuka is a moderately prominent tech blogger, respected, perhaps a bit vitriolic. He catches my attention, though, because historically he has been very critical of Parallax in his posts. Recently, though, the tone has been increasingly moderate, and now he's almost effusive in his praise. His fans are accusing him of shilling for the company, but many of his earliest posts show some of the same manipulations that we saw from Augmented Eye and Nova's blog. Now it's like he's been ghostwritten entirely. Okay, lead the way then. Couldn't hurt to check, right? I marked the location for Shotaro Otsuka's apartment on your map. After you, Flint. Okay. I'm gonna save.
to Otsuka. Okay, I saved. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna end the stream. I'm gonna do a few things, some chores, some stuff. I'll be back soon, and then I will play Enter the Gungeon, which is gonna be a lot of fun. So see you guys in a bit. Have a good one.